My name's Jenny Van Sickle. I was born and raised in Alaska. Was there until I was probably 18 or 19, left, started doing some traveling, ended up in Portland, Maine, graduated from the University of Maine, Augusta, in mental health and human service. After I graduated from that program, transferred into the social work program at UWS, where I got my bachelor's in social work, graduated in 2016. Got connected with community action through an internship. And actually, I interviewed to be an intern for the position that I now have in kind of a strange turn of events. And I've been here a little over a year. So my primary work here at Community Action, it really fell under like a pretty broad spectrum of just transportation equity. Jumpstart is like our foundation of programming here at Community Action Duluth. It's been here for, I think, just about a decade. An important program for folks that are kind of in between. There's a sweet spot with Jumpstart. So folks that have steady income from employment, sometimes that can be a big factor. But had some struggles, right? We were all 18, we all got those credit cards, and it's really easy to make a lot of mistakes early in life when you don't have the sort of financial literacy or coaching or models and resources to care for your credit as a young adult. It's a big job. So what we do is with folks looking to get financed, you know, we'll take a look at their credit report, we'll take a look at their income, because the point is we want to make sure that we're being ethical with their own finances, right? We don't want to put people in a position where a car is now somehow a financial burden rather than an asset for their families. So it's a long-term engagement program. The life of the loan typically is about 5 years. So folks come to us, we do some financial coaching, and the model of Jumpstart is that we get folks into a reliable vehicle that's newer in year, lower in miles, and higher in fuel efficiency. Folks can expect to spend anywhere from like $9,000 to $12,000. And then they have a case manager for 5 years. And I think what's really special when it comes to the work with the credit unions in town is not only are they guaranteed a low interest loan, which makes a big difference over the life of the loan in terms of affordability, they build relationships with the folks at the credit union. And I think that has a lot to do with building their own social capital and networks in town. So I think that's just sort of an added bonus. Some of the other work we do on a broader community level is focused on transportation equity. So that can be a lot of active transportation work. Bike Plus is a program that we have, I think we're in our third season now. It's a big deal. That cohort has grown exponentially. And these folks, you know, they get a refurbished bike, and really sometimes that's the difference between keeping your job and being able to access the grocery store and other sort of job opportunities, education, mental health, wellness. I think what we have seen Bike Plus do has been really impressive over the course of the last 3 years. Lots of folks losing weight, lots of folks getting involved, but the plus piece is what really makes it sort of special. Folks have really become an intricate sort of part of the process when it comes to community design, planning, and policy. Folks showing up at public input meetings, folks, you know, writing letters and talking about bike lanes are not a recreational sort of issue. This is a transportation issue in terms of how we design our community for folks that are more vulnerable, don't have a driver's license, things like that. In about the year that I've been here, one of the calls I get most often are, do you just have money for repairs? Because folks can be, you know, trucking right along, something happens, $300-$400, that will throw a family's budget off completely. We started doing some planning with our Participant Advisory Council here at Community Action and just started saying, like, what do you need? What's out there? And designing a program not just for our participants. I want to make sure that it's available to the community at large. So trying to design that, we should roll that out very soon. It's a big deal because it doesn't exist here. My name's Jenny Van Sickle. I was born and raised in Alaska. Was there until I was probably 18 or 19, left, started doing some traveling, ended up in Portland, Maine, graduated from the University of Maine Augusta in Mental Health and Human Service. After I graduated from that program, transferred into the social work program at UWS, where I got my bachelor's in social work, graduated in 2016. Got connected with Community Action through an internship. And actually, I interviewed to be an intern for the position that I now have in kind of a strange turn of events. And I've been here a little over a year. So my primary work here at Community Action, it really fell under like a pretty broad spectrum of just transportation equity. Jumpstart is like our foundation of programming here at Community Action Duluth. It's been here for, I think, just about a decade. An important program for folks that are kind of in between. There's a sweet spot with Jumpstart. So folks that have a steady income from employment, sometimes that can be a big factor. But had some struggles, right? We were all 18, we all got those credit cards, and it's really easy to make a lot of mistakes early in life when you don't have the sort of financial literacy or coaching or models and resources to care for your credit as a young adult. It's a big job. So what we do is with folks looking to get financed, you know, we'll take a look at their credit report, we'll take a look at their income, because the point is we want to make sure that we're being ethical with their own finances, right? We don't want to put people in a position where a car is now somehow a financial burden rather than an asset for their families. So it's a long-term engagement program. The life of the loan typically is about 5 years. So folks come to us, we do some financial coaching, and the model of Jumpstart is that we get folks into a reliable vehicle that's newer in year, lower in miles, and higher in fuel efficiency. Folks can expect to spend anywhere from like $9,000 to $12,000. And then they have a case manager for 5 years. And I think what's really special when it comes to the work with the credit unions in town is not only are they guaranteed a low interest loan, which makes a big difference over the life of the loan in terms of affordability, they build relationships with the folks at the credit union, and I think that has a lot to do with building their own social capital and networks in town. So I think that's just sort of an added bonus. Some of the other work we do on a broader community level is focused on transportation equity. So that can be a lot of active transportation work. Bike Plus is a program that we have, I think we're in our third season now. It's a big deal. That cohort has grown exponentially. And these folks, you know, they get a refurbished bike, and really sometimes that's the difference between keeping your job and being able to access the grocery store and other sort of job opportunities, education, mental health, wellness. I think what we have seen Bike Plus do has been really impressive over the course of the last 3 years. Lots of folks losing weight, lots of folks getting involved, but the plus piece is what really makes it sort of special. Folks have really become an intricate sort of part of the process when it comes to community design, planning, and policy. Folks showing up at public input meetings, folks, you know, writing letters and talking about bike lanes are not a recreational sort of issue. This is a transportation issue in terms of how we design our community for folks that are more vulnerable, don't have a driver's license, things like that. In about the year that I've been here, one of the calls I get most often are, do you just have money for repairs? Because folks can be, you know, trucking right along, something happens, $300-$400, that will throw a family's budget off completely. We started doing some planning with our Participant Advisory Council here at Community Action and just started saying, like, what do you need? What's out there? And designing a program not just for our participants. I want to make sure that it's available to the community at large. So trying to design that, we should roll that out very soon. It's a big deal because it doesn't exist here.